I'm giving you another test right now. If your bitch that you're currently with does not make money, if she doesn't have a store, a boutique, or trying, if she posts anything online other than links to her shop, her channel, or where people can buy her shit at, tell that bitch to delete her shit right now. If she can't do it, get your shit and dip. I'm telling you this now, because in just a second, you're going to have some issues. Anyone who has an issue detaching from a false, fabricated world is not someone that you want to be with. That time that you spend on that false world, you can be building in the real one. I need to get out of here, man, because I see ain't nobody listening. Ain't nobody fucking listening. Let me get the fuck out of here, man. Turn this shit off. You motherfuckers ain't even...
Shouts out to my nigga Big Fat Podcast, man. Hey, yo, Consaco, man. Pack J Touchdown. Are you serious? Yeah, man. Yeah, got my kit. You know what I'm talking about? Man, y'all go subscribe to Big Fat Podcast, man, on YouTube. Are you serious? Fuck, nigga.
Don't nobody believe your New Year's resolution no more. You ain't do it last year. You ain't do it the year before that, and your bitch been gave up hope. For all my niggas who's really trying to get right, right now, get with Tally P. This shit together, big homes. Hey, look here, dawg. Welcome back to the Big Facts Podcast. I am AO Consaco, fearless leader of AO Nation. Fearless. And this is... Are you fucking serious? Whenever you see this fucking vest, all the, you know, old timers, you know what I'm saying, know what this vest means. We gotta talk about some shit, dog. DJ Akademiks just called the police on his hoe. The bitch just tried to kill him, stab him in the house. I don't know what hoe it was, whether it was, I'm pretty sure it's the ex-girlfriend and shit like that. Also, pay no mind to that shit. But he called the police on the bitch. Apparently, he had to barricade himself in the room and shit like that. The bitch was coming through doors and shit like that with the knife and shit like that. And, That's one part of it. The second part of it is this bitch. They played a clip before all this happened about this hoe's mindset. So it was his ex-girlfriend. This bitch's mindset on why she wasn't a fucking leech. This nigga got her a separate apartment from his. Nigga spent like, what was it? Damn near $10,000 for the whole time she was there. I don't know how the fuck that shit worked, whatever like that. But he was working the everyday struggle shit at Complex, whatever like that. And it might have been before that shit. But he bought her a apartment in New Jersey just for her to stay in. You know what I'm saying? He moved the bitch from Michigan. Put her in the house. I don't give a fuck about, you know what I'm saying, Akademiks as, you know what I'm saying, whatever the fuck. Right now, I want to speak to you as, you know what I'm saying, niggas and shit like that. Because some of y'all are still not awake to the fact of what these bitches are trying to do to you. If you have your shit together already, a lot of my niggas in AO Nation, most of y'all have y'all shit together as far as making money and shit like that. No, you're not working at Burger King and shit like that. You actually have a career and shit like that. And you have shit going for yourself. And you might bump into a bitch that look good, whatever like that. And you have to understand how she's looking at you. So we're going to break that part down. And then I want y'all to hear what this bitch said, how she rationalizes her being in a apartment, not paying no rent, not paying no bill, whatever like that. How she fixes that shit in her mind to where she's not a fucking leech. No, you're not a leech. You're a prostitute. A very expensive prostitute. And I want you niggas to apply the same method. Hoes. If the bitch... see, this where the shit gets shaky, because I just told you. I just told you, dog, in the last video with Cardi B and Offset, that I actually kind of prefer this, the dynamic where it's the bitch be the housewife and shit like that. But that was the thing. It was housewife. And on top of that shit, knowing whether or not a bitch, that's why you have to listen and understand and hit me up, you know what I'm saying, if you got some questions about some shit, whatever like that, because you got to be able to read a hoe. Finding a soulmate is not like going to the store and picking out which fucking pear and oranges are right for eating and shit like that. It's far more difficult. You're not trying to find something that's going to be, you know what I'm saying, microwave. You're trying to find something for a lifetime, so it's not going to be all easy peasy. It's going to be a task. You understand? And there's a lot of games and tricks out here to be played, and that's why we have to talk about this shit, because I'm seeing that we do have a lot of confused niggas out here as far as it goes. If you a lame-ass nigga, understand this. Please understand this. Everybody has to go through being lame, not being hip to shit, whatever like that. You have to go through that. In order to get to being knowledgeable about anything, you have to first be ignorant of it. And then, but you, what separates you is you have that, I want to learn. You have that urge. I want to learn what's going on. I want to be more knowledgeable about this. Like, a nigga who can't eat pussy. That was a very bad example. That was a bad, shout out to Big C. like, you understand what the fuck I'm saying, man. I'm throwed off by this shit, man, because I just did a video about, I did this video damn near 2 weeks ago, shot Big C again, because we were talking about a situation, and he felt like a street nigga shouldn't call the police on a hoe. And I had to explain to him, like, hold up, whoa. Ain't no, you can't fight no hoe, my nigga. Until shit starts changing around, you put them bitches to work. That's part of getting your shit together. Getting your shit together don't mean I done ran it up on the coke, I done ran it up on the dog food. No, my nigga. Getting your shit together mean I have a legitimate way of making money to where nobody can fuck with me. I'm not under nobody's scrutiny. This is all me. I run everything around me. All me. This is all me right here. So that if anybody, you know what I'm saying, challenges your way of life, whatever like that, you can take the proper steps to where you keep your freedom and your life and your peace. You put them bitches to work. So that was a discussion they had, that we had to speak about and shit like that. And plus the fact, if the bitch calls the police on you, it's over with. Ain't no questions asked. As a street nigga, as an ex-street nigga, your record says that you're a criminal. When they come on the scene after being called on you, it's not going to be no questions asked. Look at his record. Pull Aaron Lewis. Felon. It's fucked up. It's over with for you. Ain't no talking. You know what I'm saying? So call the police on that hoe just as soon as she raises her voice. Or if she come to the house unannounced. Whoa, what the fuck going on? What the fuck this motherfucker doing? That's why I got the cameras. What the fuck going on? You know what I'm saying? But he had to call the police on the hoe because she had a knife and shit like that. And I was very smart to barricade himself in the room. That's why it's so dangerous to stay with a hoe. What happened in this situation with that right there? This bitch has been trying to get a child from this lame ass nigga since she came in this shit. and it hasn't worked out. Once you hear the way this hoe talks, you can tell that this is one of the bitches that are gonna say, I don't believe in abortion. We were in love. This was it that he explained to me that we were gonna be in love. A bitch that mixes up the world in her mind and then excretes the bullshit onto the world. You know what I'm saying? One of these loving hip hop hoes. You know goddamn well that a nigga is living a lifestyle that is not. That does not run parallel to the lifestyle of a fucking parent or a responsible adult even. Nothing about this person says that they are ready to be a parent before any talks come into the picture. Nothing about this man says father. Nothing about this man says responsible. But what this man does say without speaking a word is, I'm financially stable. I will go out there and work for mine. And that's what a bitch sees. She don't give a fuck about you. No, none of that shit right there. She'll even go for the potential of a nigga, you know what I'm saying, getting some fucking money. And depending on how low you go, bitch just needs some sperm. The government's gonna help me. Fuck the goddamn child. Because we already know the child has a better chance of winning with a two-parent home. You know that once you drop the bomb of being a parent on this nigga, he's going to leave. But you don't give a fuck about the child. I'm finna talk to you, dog. I wanted to do a story. I wanted to do two stories. One story on a white man that donated his sperm to a sperm bank. Lesbians came in, got the sperm, had a child. 5 years later, they put this goddamn man on child support. Do you know that a judge signed off on that shit? Donate means I give it because it's needed out of the kindness of my heart. If I donate blood, donate plasma, motherfucker get paid for that shit. I never did that shit, but I probably would have did that shit. When I was down, man, I probably would have did that shit, but I never did that shit. I never got into that shit. I think because I like, if you got too many tattoos or some shit, that was the reason why I couldn't do it. But for the most part, when you donate blood, it's just for free. They give you cookies. I'm trying to help people and shit like that. I'm donating sperm so that the LGBT community can live out their dreams of having a child. How do I get repaid for my kindness? I get put on child support like your average, everyday nigga. Check garnishings. Could you fucking imagine, my nigga? Let that shit sink in. Let that shit sink in, dog. Because at times, my ferocity could be mistaken for hatred of the wrong party. What I hate is that the system is so corrupt that it continues to let this happen. We know that the child support system is fucked, and we also know that if there wasn't a financial incentive, we wouldn't have all of these children out of wedlock. If you take away the government assistance for a bitch having a baby, a bitch wouldn't go run after an NBA star and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? A bitch wouldn't be doing all that gold digging ass shit. They wouldn't do it. Everything would be about love, and if we want to do this shit. Do I want to be a parent? Do I trust this man? But as long as the hoe got a safety net, the hoe can just jump out the fucking window. Fuck it if he do, fuck it if he don't. I don't give a fuck. I'm good. And it, and that kind of ties into the rap trap for the reason of it sets a precedent, and it teaches through experience, it teaches the younger generation to be reckless. The same way that Kodak Black, Rich the Kid, and all these motherfucking retarded motherfuckers that get on in the game and shit like that for not being skilled in their music, but just for being an example of what the CIA agents want our youth, the black youth, to be. You know what I'm saying? We want you to be like this. Why the fuck are you going to school? You can just be a rapper. Kodak did it. You hear what he talk about? He was making it from the bottom. Follow your rap career at 9 years old. And it's so fucking throw it off that they got these 'nothing-ass bitches' to go along with it. Lil got it. I did the story on Lil got it. His mama was in the tattoo parlor with him, getting tatted up. This bitch would go to the club with him and pass out his flyers and shit like that. And you can call that a supportive mother, but that's not what that is. A mother don't want you to, you know, like, look what you're talking about. You can't talk about that in my house. Take your ass, what the fuck are you talking about? You talking about killing folks and doing dope. You're not respecting me with that. You're not giving me no honor with that. You can't do that around me. It's what a... So with the child support system, they're teaching the same shit. Hey, little 12-year-old girl, no matter what happens, you good. You don't have to give a fuck about trust and love. You can make this nigga do whatever. You think he gonna stand up to the whole government? You got the whole government on your side. What you tripping on? The baby gonna be straight because y'all could just live off love. Because you ain't gonna have to pay nothing. All you gotta do is take care of the baby. And if you get, and that's what family for. If you get tired, you can hand them to your mama. You still got your whole life to live. Go ahead and have your child. I want some grandkids. Then the child grows up to be one of these rappers or wannabe rappers and goes to prison, and that's the pussy to prison pipeline. They're hitting us from all corners. But that's what happened in this situation with DJ Akademiks. The bitch was tired of fucking waiting. Like, God damn it, why haven't I got this nigga yet? We did tests to make sure he was fertile, make sure I was fertile. This nigga won't take the fucking condom off. God damn, we've been fucking for how long? Like, what the fuck, my nigga? Take the goddamn condom off. You trying to do shit to make the shit work and shit like that, and there's nothing's working. These bitches do not want to be up under these lame-ass niggas. That's why I need you to understand whether or whether or not you are that nigga or you're the lame nigga. Because it can, like, this whole, a bitch will treat Rich the Kid or one of these lame-ass rap niggas like they are that. Shout out to Katrina Gibbs. Go watch Conversation with Me. Like, if you a lame ass nigga, and that's why the hoe wants you, but you still a lame ass nigga. And she can see that. These nothing ass IG models have said the easiest niggas to run any game on is the rap niggas. These niggas ain't, I'm trying, these are real fucking video gamers. Run a checkup on these niggas and run down the road. Black China has shouldered better than anybody on the planet. Lame ass niggas. And this bitch right here, her name is Angelica or some shit like that. She wanted her fucking come up, and when she didn't get it, like, God damn it, I'm tired of being in this fucking house with this goddamn fuck. And all the bitches know it. All the IG thought bitches know it. Like, I know she hates being over that motherfucker. Look at this nigga. Listen to him. This bitch wanna be on Love and Hip Hop. You can tell by the way the whole talk. Matter of fact, let's listen to that shit. Let's listen to this whole talk.
Little my nails doesn't buy me gifts, nothing. Our relationship was just based off of love. That's it. Nothing else. He did that out of the kindness of his heart without me asking. So it was never about love. Ever. I mean, not love. It was about love. It was never about money. He's still living at his house rent-free. Okay. Me and him got a place together. We specifically got this apartment to live with each other. How is he paying my rent if he lives here as well? He uses the water. He sleeps here. He eats the food here. He uses the electricity here. How is that? It benefits us, not me. Benefits us. If I were to leave, he would still be paying rent for himself. I'm here because we're together. Like, we decided we wanted to live together. We made that decision that we wanted to move in together. And we're staying together. Like, no way around it. So when you guys want to be like, oh, he's doing this and that for you, it's not, it does not only benefit me. So how could I be taking advantage of him if it's mutual? Definitely not a leech, because I too contribute to the house. When just like yesterday, AK needed money. I gave him like $3 to go to the vending machine. He needed cash. Like, I gave him cash. Like, okay, it's $3, but I'm just saying. And like, I buy groceries. Like, I buy groceries here more times than he has ever bought groceries here. On top of that, like, I've spent a lot of money on gifts for him. I've given him more gifts than he's ever given me. I've paid for a dinner. When we go out to eat, I've paid for dinner. It's not a problem. It's balances. It's a balanced relationship. So to sit there and just be like, oh, you're leech, you doing this, I feel like I don't fit under the definition of a leech, because I'm contributing, you know, in a way. I'm not taking advantage. What he does is for us. It's not for me. It doesn't only benefit me. He lives here as well. You're his sugar mama. Not at all. It's just love. Just love. I've paid for Ubers when he asked me to. Even voluntarily. For his friends. To have nothing to do with me. For his friends.
I want you to listen to what this hoe just said. I want you to listen to what this hoe just said. And I want you to imagine if a dude said that. What would that be? The bitch said, how is, how am I living rent free if we live here together? These are the same hoes. This is the same bitch that talks about it's supposed to be a 50-50 relationship. You tell me, what's 50-50 about this bitch? I pay the bills. I every. Let's just do the cheat sheet. You fuck, I fuck. You buy groceries, I buy groceries. Let's just say that. Let's just say it, fuck. I pay all the bills. How's that 50-50? My second question is, if it was a fat bitch that said that shit, dog, a fat, unattractive bitch that said, how in the fuck am I living rent-free if he lives here too? How much merit would you give it? And this is for you females out there who ride with shit like this. Understand, the majority of you, if you said this shit, a nigga will laugh at you. A nigga requires for you to come 50 fucking 50. Requires it. But this bitch, I just get to live here and live free. And the bitch get an allowance. And this bitch sit here in this fucking bed, in this fucking air condition. On a nigga's fucking phone that he pays for, and talk about it's love. Cause you can go down there to Alabama Power and give the motherfuckers $100 worth of love, and your life won't get cut off. You can go down there to the water, Riviera, and give them $200 worth of love, and you can still use the goddamn toilet. You can go give the rent office $400 worth of love, and your shit won't be outside. That's how the world works. 21 Savage. 21 Savage, on the last interview he did, said, fuck that love shit, show me loyalty, because you can show that. You can show loyalty. Love is just, I love you. That's the most you can do, is just, I say I love you. That's the most you can do. While we fucking or some shit like that in the car, I love you, sentimental moment. Show me loyalty. Is this loyalty? Dog, do you understand a bitch will say that I could have been exposed? I could have went on the internet and exposed you, but I didn't. That's loyalty. Hold on, bitch. That's your, so your definition of loyalty is being my friend and not doing snake shit. Hold on. Hold on. Loyalty is going up and above and beyond the call of duty. So if friends are supposed to do this, you do this right here. You don't just stay here and say, well, see, I didn't go down here, and I could have. Are you used to doing snake shit, bitch? Are you used to doing snake shit? Listen to these motherfuckers that you have around you. If they're on social media, leave them immediately. If I'm in a fucking relationship, the first goddamn call of duty is, if you don't have a store and you're not making money, if you don't already have something going on the internet, delete your social media. If you can't do it, I holler at you. Love, love. That's the first call. That's the first order of damn duty. If you can't do that, then ride. Ride. Because that already lets you know what's going on. If the motherfucker have a hard time detaching from this false, manipulated, fabricated world, you need to give them that. My nigga, I gave y'all the test about telling your homeboys, your white homeboys, to dress up like police officers and knock on the bitch door. Act like you selling coke, hide that shit somewhere, then have your white homeboy knock on the door and interrogate the bitch and see if she roll over on you. I'm giving you another test. I'm giving you another test right now. If your bitch that you're currently with does not make money, if she doesn't have a store, a boutique, or trying, if she posts anything online other than links to her shop, her channel, or where people can buy her shit at, tell that bitch to delete her shit right now. If she can't do it, get your shit and dip. I'm telling you this now, because in just a second, you're going to have some issues. Anyone who has an issue detaching from a false, fabricated world is not someone that you want to be with. That time that you spend on that false world, you can be building in the real one. I need to get out of here, man, because I see ain't nobody listening. Ain't nobody fucking listening. Let me get the fuck out of here, man. Turn this shit off. You motherfuckers ain't even listening, dog. Let me get the fuck out of this motherfucker. But these motherfuckers tripping, dog. These motherfuckers tripping, dog. Anybody who can't cut off the fake world to build in the real one is not nobody that you need to be building anything with. Every second of your fucking day should be trying to get out of your current situation. I really need to be quiet right here. I need to go on here and be quiet, but I'm gonna be honest with you, my nigga. Most my nigga dog who really doing their thing and ain't got no complaints in life are either polygamous or they fucking single, my nigga. They running that shit by themselves. They run it by themselves. They run it by themselves. Fuck who they want. Ain't nothing, nothing. Ain't nothing, nothing. Because you're going to have a hard time snatching a bitch off that fake shit. Because fake shit to a bitch feels so good. Why work out? What? Who the fuck said this shit? I think, oh, Daylight said this. Daylight said, I knew a nigga who would play 2K, and on 2K he was running on the treadmill but wouldn't work out in his real life. You know what I'm saying? When a bitch can take these pictures from this and this and this, why would the bitch have to get focused on actually losing weight? Eating healthy. Fixing her pussy so it works when she can get all these thirsty niggas in her inbox from taking these fucked up ass pictures. I say fucked up, meaning you're lying. Let me stop. Let's get back to this bitch and why she feels like she's not a leech. She feels like she's not a leech.
He uses the water. He sleeps here. He eats the food here. He uses the electricity here. How is that? It benefits us.
It benefits us, but he's paying for it. It benefits us, but he's paying for it. So we both benefit from it, but only one of us is doing something to make sure that we benefit from it. So you're a fucking parasite. You're a parasite. You eat, sleep, shit, use the electricity, and don't pay shit. He eats, sleep, shit, and pays for everything. That's normal logic, right? She knows it. But she also knows that the internet will back up her bullshit because of niggas like Ice JJ Fish. And niggas wonder why that shit was not funny to me. And that's why they fucking age restricted that Ice JJ Fish video, because I was letting it be known. The true issue is these niggas that'll get on this shit while she's talking and say, "Oh, you right, queen." And it's a Mexican bitch. "Oh yeah, you right. Oh yeah, you right, boo. Yeah, you right, boo. If he can't take care of you, I don't know what the fuck he doing." She opened up by saying, "He doesn't get my nails done. We don't go on shopping sprees. He don't get me gifts. I don't give a fuck if that was a soundbite." You don't pay the light bill, the rent, the water, and you barely have to pay for food. Nails, shopping sprees, gifts. That pretty much kill that, don't it? It's bitches out here who would love. Let me stop. That's just too much common sense. What I want you to see is, when you a lame ass nigga, you take this type of shit. Like, the bitch can make you believe, like, oh, yeah, like, we're equal. It's love, so it's equal. And it would be, if she came on this bitch and said, hell yeah, he paid for everything, man. That nigga, that's that nigga, man. I swear to God. Housewife. But when you get on this bitch and act like it's equal, get the fuck out. Get the fuck out. What you can do is say nothing. But what you not gonna do is say some bullshit. What you can do is say nothing. What you not gonna do is say a lie and say a falsehood. It's not equal, bitch. There's nothing special about you. What you do, anybody can do. I can get any bitch to do to live in a lap of luxury. This bitch said that she pays for Uber and she gave this nigga $3 just the other day again. And she was dead fucking serious, my nigga. She was dead fucking serious. And the way that it gets like this is because she looks good. So motherfuckers will, all her life, she's never had to argue with anybody because someone will always step in. All she had to do was try to cry a little bit and somebody will step in. So you never have to actually have any logic because bitches that want to be you and niggas that want to fuck you will always back you up. That's why you get a lot of retarded, fine bitches. Because they've never been challenged. Anytime they get challenged, they can get some niggas to come and do something to a nigga. All kind of shit. And that's what I'm saying. Akademiks is lame, but a lot of you niggas is lame also. Because you don't have the nuts to do anything about this type of situation either. A lot of y'all are in these same type of situations. Going to give a bitch money and shit like that, knowing that she don't fuck with you like that. You just hoping and praying. You know this whole line, but you up at night thinking about the whole and shit like that. You ain't got the nuts to go check that shit or cut that shit the fuck off. I tell your bitch to get off social media. Like, bitch, you ain't making no money on here. Hey, man, I'm tired of carrying all the weight. Hey, man, you gotta cut that social media shit out. Because you know that hoe will get the fuck up and leave you, dog. Social media did this shit. This hoe was on IG Live talking to motherfuckers about how the L's and the cons of living rent-free. I'm done with it, dog. If you're not gonna do shit, dog, just keep walking how you walk, my nigga. Just keep walking how you walk. This ain't about Akademiks. It's about you, dog. Big Facts Podcast. I'm El Consaco. Make sure you hit that PayPal. Love. Crazy.